Hey Scrappers, it's Vanessa here with the last layout for sketch-inspired One Sketch Two Ways with Vanessa and Lisa. And for our last sketch, we will be doing a two-page sketch, and Lisa will be doing the traditional two-page layout based off of the sketch, and I will be creating a one-page layout based off of the sketch. And so the first thing that I'm doing here is just showing you everything that I pulled. And for this layout, I am primarily using the Pink Fresh BU collection. And I have to say, I love the colors of this collection. They're light and sort of airy colors. And I love how this layout turned out. I think of all of the layouts that I did for this series, this is probably my favorite, I think. And I think it's because I'm using this new collection, and it's so beautiful. I just love the colors in it, the pinks and the greens and that peachy color that's in this collection. So the first thing that I'm going to do here, obviously I'm not doing a two-page layout. I'm doing a take on the sketch for one page, and I did want to do a little bit of mixed media. Nothing too crazy, just something really simple. I did not prime my paper, so I'm just using a very little bit of water and a little bit of spray in the Shimmers color. I believe it was Oh Say Can You See, and I'm doing sort of an ombre effect where I'm just taking a wide paintbrush and I'm just making strokes down the page. And I did sort of three that were a little darker and then two that are lighter. And so that is going to be my background. And because I did not use a ton of water, it does warp a little bit, but it doesn't warp nearly as much as it probably would have if I had used a whole lot more water. And that piece of paper there, I'm going to gut the center of it because it's beautiful and I don't want to waste all of that beautiful BU collection for just a mat behind my layout. So I'm cutting up the center so I can use the other piece later. And here I'm showing you that I'm taking another piece of that BU collection, and I'm just taking three of the squares that have the little cameras on it, and those I will use on my layout in my three clusters that I'm going to end up having. And there you see I had just cut them out off screen just so you didn't have to watch that. And the next thing that I'm going to do for this is mat my photo. And so while I'm matting my photo, I will say just a little bit about the photo itself. This photo is definitely not the best quality photo. It's actually a photo of a photo. So I had found some old pictures of, you know, my teenage years and growing up, and I took a picture with my phone of this picture and decided that I would scrap this photo. I have not really ever scrapped. I mostly scrap my kids, so I haven't really gone back and scrapped a lot of my teenage years or my, you know, growing up years or the early years when my husband and I were just dating. And so this photo happens to be a photo of my husband when he was a whole lot younger. So this picture is, I turned it black and white because the colors were definitely nothing that would go with this collection that I wanted to use for this layout. But this photo is of my husband, and he and I were, we might have just gotten engaged, maybe. We were dating, definitely. I don't know if we were we were engaged yet or not, but it was that summer. It was the summer that we got engaged, and so this is a photo of him, and he's got like the sort of 90s hair going on. And anyway, I just thought it was such a cute photo. I love it, and so I figure it was time to document some of our older photos or some of my older photos. So that is what I'm doing. So this one is definitely for my hubby, and just to say how much I love him. And so for this layout, I did, there you saw a few minutes ago on the layout, I did take and cut from my silhouette a heartbeat sort of die cut that has like a, you know, in the heartbeat, it has a heart inside there. And I will link the cut file in the video description in case anybody is interested in it. And so I'm going to use that on this layout. But the first thing that I wanted to do after my background had finished drying was they have sort of on the sketch a dotted line. I'm assuming that it would either be, you know, drawn with a pen for stitch lines or a sewing machine. But my sewing machine wasn't in a place where I could get to it. And so for this layout, I decided that instead of stitching or doing hand stitching or pen, using my pen to make the stitch lines, that I decided I would take some twine and just staple it, like you saw, all the way around each of the corners of the page to sort of mimic that stitched line. And I really love the texture and the sort of dimension that this brings to the page. It sort of frames out the layout as well as adds just some interesting detail around the edges that I think if I had used a pen, since I couldn't get to my sewing machine, it wouldn't have given quite the same effect. So I really love how it turned out. And I'm just gluing some of the twine down a little bit because, like I said, my paper was a little bit warped. So it's flat now that I've put some stuff on top of it. But at first, it was having a hard time staying flat. So I just put a little bit of glue just to keep everything sort of in place. Now, the next thing that I'm going to do here is just lay out everything that I'm going to put on this layout. And really, this whole layout did not take me that long. I think the longest time was really just waiting for everything to dry. I had a good idea in my head of how it was going to come together because obviously I'm using a sketch, so it's pretty easy to figure out the placement of everything. The cut file that you see there is going to go there at the bottom. And then you see the three clusters that I'm going to have there, one to the side of the title. There's going to be another one at the top. And so I'm just laying out my title here, and I'm using some thickers for heart and beat. And then I believe these little tiny letter stickers are from Pink Fresh, one of their older collections. It's probably a couple years old now, but I love the sort of scriptiness of the letters. And so I had two colors of them, a lighter pink and a darker pink, and they work perfectly, obviously, because it's Pink Fresh and I'm using a Pink Fresh collection. Everything sort of, their colors always seem to work together. So it went perfectly with the layout and the feel that I was going for. And of course, because it's my husband, my title is, of course, My Heart Skips a Beat. Because even after being married for 21 years, my heart still skips a beat when I see him. So this is definitely a layout for him. I have journaling that I will put on the back, just talking about my hubby. So I don't have any that'll go on the front. It's really, I kept this layout pretty simple. Kind of looks like the sketch, and it kind of veers away from it a little bit. I do keep some of the elements, like I said, the stitching sort of concept around the edge. I have three clusters, but a lot of this is sort of interpreted from the sketch, I would say, which is the best thing about having a sketch, right? Is you use it for a jumping off point. So now that I've gotten everything laid out, like I said, I keep everything really simple, and because I'm using that one collection and a lot of pieces from it, apart from adding some finishing touches of enamel dots and some puffy hearts, this layout comes together extremely quickly. So you'll just see I'm going to put the enamel dots around the page in my three little clusters, and I'm going to glue it all down off camera, and that completes this layout. So guys, thank you so much for coming along with us for this sketch series. I hope you enjoyed it. And remember, if you play along, leave a note in the description and you'll be in for a drawing for a $20 gift card for scrapbook.com that I'll draw for at the end of June. So thanks everybody, and have a great day. Bye-bye.